पोको फ्लेक्सी कॉइल एच टाइप बॉलस्टर बोगी। WIP-4 and WIP-1 locos are provided with the Coco Flexi Coil bogie. This bogie has two types of suspension, the primary suspension and a secondary suspension. As you all know, primary suspension is the suspension provided between axle box and bogie frame, whereas secondary suspension is the suspension provided between bogie frame and loco body. On each axle box, one pair of Helgel springs are provided and are called as primary springs. On these primary springs, bogie frame is mounted. Stay plate is provided below the axle box. The specialty of stay plate is in this loco is it will see that axle box is not escaping from the horns, and also it holds the loco brake rigging. Bogie frame have four springs pockets, two in each side. On each pocket, one pair of Helgel springs are provided and called as secondary springs. On the secondary springs, H-type baluster is provided. On the center of the baluster, loco body is mounted by the help of a center pivot. On the center of the baluster, loco body is mounted by the help of center pivot. Entire vertical load is carried by baluster through center pivot. Right side of a baluster is provided with the friction motor. What is this friction motor? This friction motor consists of a phenolic piston, steel washer and a spring, which contain within a cylindrical housing in the baluster. So the purpose of the friction device is to have high friction between baluster and bogie. It is provided for a damping in both vertical and lateral modes of oscillation. All four ends of baluster is provided with side stoppers. Between two side beams of bogie frame, four cross beams are provided and are called as transoms. Traction motors arrangement in this bogie is LLR, LRR. So middle transoms are used for holding the traction motors and end transoms are used for holding the loco brake rigging. Each bogie is equipped with six brake cylinders. Each brake cylinder will control one wheel. Clasp type brake rigging arrangement provided in this type of bogie. Traction motor arrangement in this is also axially hung and nose suspended. Nose portion is suspended on transom by the help of a resilient block. Handbrake is connected to brake cylinder number 2, so both brake blocks of wheel number 2 will apply when handbrake is applied. Only Hitachi type traction motors are provided in this. The loco body weight is transferred to the baluster through center pivot. The load of the locomotive superstructure rests on this center pivot and center pivot bowel of the bogies. This bowel is fitted with the phenolic oil lubricated vertical and horizontal liners, which provided rotational freedom between body and bogie in operation. The steel casted H-type baluster is supported on the steel casted bogie frame at four corners by pair of helical springs. These helical springs placed in springs pockets of main longitudinal member of the bogie frame. The baluster is located with respect to bogie frame by upright pedestals in which are integral part of the bogie frame. This arrangement serves to transmit the tractive and braking force from baluster to the bogie and vice versa. In this bogie, lateral stops are also provided on the baluster as well as on the bogie frame to limit the side movement of flexing action of the. So now the vertical load of the loco body will transfer to the bogie and bogie will transfer the vertical load to the axles. Similarly, the braking force which is coming from the axle box axles is transferred to the bogie and bogie will transfer these tractive end forces to the loco body through baluster and vice versa.
Bogie parts. Axle box with the primary helical springs. These are the axle blocks and primary helical springs. Bogie horns. These are the bogie horns. Bogie. So this is the bogie. Stay plate. Spring pocket. This is the spring pocket. Where on bogie, baluster is resting on these secondary springs, secondary helical springs.
These are the secondary helical springs. Center pivot. So it is the center pivot. H-type baluster. This is the H-type baluster. Bogie frame. This is bogie frame. Transoms. These are the four transoms on bogie. Brake cylinder. So these are the brake cylinders. Brake rigging. The brake rigging gear. Friction motor. It is the friction motor. It is the friction motor. The friction motor, it consists of a phenolic piston, steel washer and a spring contained in the cylindrical housing in the baluster. In this baluster housing, this type of one spring piston and a steel washer is provided. Hitachi type traction motor. Suspension bearing. TM gear case. So this is the TM gear case. Coco flexi coil bogie. So in brief we will see what are the items available in a flexi coil bogie. So number one, so one sanding box. So you all know the sanding arrangement. So sanding box, this is 1 and 12 sanding box. Next, second one is wheel flange lubrication reservoir. So right now it is not in service. Primary suspension damper. So dampers are provided in this. So primary suspension means the damper which is provided between the axle and bogie. Hence this damper is called as a primary damper, primary vertical damper. Secondary suspension add damper. Secondary suspension add damper. So these are the add dampers. So it is provided in secondary, that is between loco bogie and loco body. So WFL, wheel flange lubrication reservoir. WFL present currently not in service. Secondary suspension spring. So here two helical springs you can see. So these springs are called as secondary suspension springs. These springs are provided between bogie and loco body. Hence these springs are called as secondary suspension springs. Next, safety chain. To avoid the excessive oscillations, avoid the movement, excessive movement between the loco body and loco bogie, the safety chain is provided. Secondary suspension vertical damper. So here another vertical damper is provided and is provided between the loco bogie and loco body. And this suspension arrangement is called as secondary suspension, and it is provided in vertical direction. Hence this damper is called as vertical damper. Next, horizontal damper. So this is horizontal damper. This horizontal damper is provided between the bogie and loco body, but it is in horizontal condition. Hence it is called as a horizontal damper. 9. Horizontal damper. So horizontal damper is in horizontal condition, hence it is called as a horizontal damper. So wheel set guide rod. So one end connected to the axle box, another end connected to the bogie. Next, bogie frame. Already discussed the bogie frame. This is the bogie frame. Next, wheel set arrangement in which wheel set rod connects to the axle is called wheel set. So here the wheel set is there. So three wheel set guide rods are there. Hence three wheel set are available each side of the bogie. So these are the wheels. Next, brake blocks. So the braking arrangement. So here the brake blocks are provided. In three phase loco, initially TBUs are provided, tread braking units are provided. Brake blocks, already discussed the brake blocks. Brake lever. So these are the brake levers. Brake cylinders. Brake rod. Primary suspension spring. It means between axle and loco bogie, so the suspension arrangement whichever is provided is called as a primary suspension. Is called as a primary suspension. Each axle having the primary springs on which bogie is resting. Wheel flange. So this is wheel flange which is common in all bogies. Sanding arrangement. Next, 22 traction link.
So on one end of the bogie, here traction link is provided. So this traction link, one end connected to the bogie, on the other end it is connected to the loco body. So one end it is connected to the bogie and another end it is connected to the loco body. So in undergear examination, you have to check all these items. In the upcoming topics, we will see each and every item how it is. So in this, how the vertical load and tractive forces are carrying. Let us see that loco weight is transferred to bogie through the springs. The bogie will transfer the vertical load to axle box through these primary springs. Vertical load is carrying by the bogie. This bogie, whatever the vertical load is taken by the axle, will transfer the same load to wheel. Now the wheel transfer the same amount of load which is taken by the axle is now transfers to the rails. So then what about the tractive and braking forces? Your traction motor is rotating, TM pinion starts rotating, TM pinion is connected to the bull gear, bull gear starts rotating, bull gear is connected to the axle, axle starts rotating. Whenever axle is rotating, on each ends wheels are provided and wheel starts rotating. Whenever wheel starts rotating, one end is connected to the wheel set guide rod. Now wheel set guide rod will take that tractive force to the body. Here whenever axle is moving, so that axle's tractive force is now transferred to bogie with the help of a wheel set guide rod, and all the wheels are connected with, to the bogie with the help of wheel set guide rods. So the tractive forces are now transferred to the wheel sets, and the wheel set guide rods will transfer the whatever the tractive force they are receiving to the bogie. And bogie's one end is connected to the traction link, and bogie's other end is connected to the loco body. This loco body will now carry the total tractive force. So whenever loco body is moving, loco body one end is connected to the CBC. CBC also starts moving. When CBC is moving, your formation is moving. So the vertical load which is exerted by the loco body is transferred to the bogie through secondary helical springs. The bogie which carries the vertical load will be transferred to the each axle with the help of primary springs. The axle which receives the vertical load will transfer the same vertical load to the rails with the help of wheels. But whereas in case of tractive and braking forces, whenever the traction motor is rotating, traction motor pinion rotates the bull gear. When bull gear rotates, axle rotating. When axle rotating, wheels are rotating. When axle is moving, wheels are rotating. When axle is moving, at that time wheel set guide rod takes that tractive force and carries to the bogie. Each wheel is having one wheel set guide rod. So whenever axle is exerting the tractive force, that tractive force will be absorbed by the wheel set guide rod, and each wheel set guide rod will transfer that particular tractive force to the bogie. So one end of the bogie is connected to the traction link. So your traction link will carry the all the tractive force of the all wheels, all axles. The traction link another end is connected to the loco body. So now the loco body also starts moving. Whenever loco body starts moving, then loco body's one end is connected to the CBC. Your CBC also now starts moving. If any load is attached to the CBC or TS coupling, that particular load also starts moving. Coco flexi coil, three phase bogie. The springs provided in middle wheel set are provided with the inner springs. Wheel set is connected to the bogie frame by the help of wheel set guide rod. Every axle cup is provided with the side stopper. On these primary springs, bogie frame is mounted. Between end axle box, bogie frame vertical dampers are provided and called as a primary suspension vertical dampers. On each wheel set, one pair of helical springs are provided and are called as primary helical springs. On bogie frame, one pair of helical springs are provided in each side of bogie and called as secondary springs. On these secondary springs, loco body is mounted. Near middle axle box and loco body, vertical damper 1 in each side is provided and called as secondary suspension vertical damper. Between bogie frame and loco body, air dampers are provided on 1 in each side of bogie. Between bogie frame and loco body, horizontal dampers are provided 1 in each side of bogie. Between two side beams of bogie frame, 2 cross beams are provided and are called as transoms.
3 transoms
are used for holding the traction motors. The transoms towards the center of the loco is provided with the traction link. This traction link other end is connected to the loco body by the help of a traction frame. The traction motors are suspended in the bogie frame and on the individual axles. The motors transmit their energy to the driving axles through a gearbox mounted on the driving axle. Safety chain is provided between the bogie frame and loco body and provided at the center axle. So we will discuss the bogie parts. So this is the axle box. Primary helical spring. So above the axle box and bogie. Bogie frame. So this is the bogie frame. Wheel set guide rod with bolts and nuts. This is wheel set guide rod. Wheel set guide rods, one end is connected to axle and another end connected to the bogie. Wheel set. This is wheel set. Safety link on middle axle box. This is the safety link provided between axle and bogie. Vertical shock absorber on end axles. On each bogie, on end axles, primary vertical shock absorbers are provided. Secondary helical springs. These are the secondary helical springs provided between bogie and loco body. Secondary vertical dampers. Secondary vertical dampers. These are provided between bogie and loco body. Hence, it is called as secondary vertical damper. Air damper. So these are the air dampers. So air dampers are provided in secondary, that is between a bogie and a loco body. Horizontal damper. So these are also provided. These are also provided in the secondary suspension, that is between bogie and loco body. Here in three directions these three dampers are provided. For example, if you see the XYZ axis, these three dampers are provided in three axes. One is vertical, one is horizontal damper, and the third one is air damper. Traction link bolts. This is very, very important. So traction link, one end is provided with 6 bolts, 3 plus 3, 6 bolts, whereas bottom plate is provided with 6 plus 6 bolts, total 12 bolts. It means each end it is provided with 6 bolts of traction link and a 12 bolt bottom plate. Traction link. This is the traction link. So bogie end. So it is the bogie end. So here traction link end is connected to the bogie. So body end, loco body end. This end of the traction link is connected to the loco body. So you have to check the bolts of traction link at both the ends. That is 6 bolts on, 6 bolts on bogie end, 6 bolts on body end. Similarly, axle plate, bottom plate is having 6 plus 6 bolts. So you have to observe this 6 plus 6 bolts at each end. That is bogie end and body end. Three phase squirrel cage induction motor. It is the induction motor. Three phase induction motor. TM no suspension. In conventional bogie, so traction motor arrangement is axle hung nose suspended. Here also, in three phase loco also, TM arrangement is axle hung nose suspended. But here nose is suspended with the help of torque arm. Whereas in conventional loco bogies, nose is suspended in a transom by the help of the resilient block. So here there is no resilient block. Here one item is provided which holds the TM nose, and that item is called as a torque arm. So the torque arm, one end is connected to the TM and another end is connected to the bogie. TM gear case. So this is the TM gear case. In this coco flexi coil three phase loco bogie, in TM gear case oil is provided in place of cardan compound. TM cables, these are the cables for TM. So it is a three phase motor, hence three cables along with this three cables, two additional cables also provided. Air bellows, these are the air bellows. Safety chain, so safety chain is provided at middle axle. MCP with the safety sling, so main compressors are provided with the safety slings. So during examination you have to check the slackness of the safety sling. MCP bed bolts, so these are the MCP bed bolts. Left side one bed bolt, if you see the right side it will having two bed bolts. MCP oil point, so these are the oil points in some locos. So spyglass is provided in some locos, one oil point is provided, whereas some locos are provided with the oil free compressors. Bogie cock, so it is a bogie isolation cock. Unloader valve cock, so unloader valve cock is provided above battery box number 2. Traction link safety slings, so safety slings are provided for traction links. Due to any reason, if traction link bolts are missing or traction link is in broken condition, to avoid the dropping on the track, these safety slings are provided. Brake cylinder, so WP7 locos are modified with the conventional brake cylinders. What are the important items to be checked in a bogie? So in undergear examination you have to check the several items regarding a bogie. So what are that items? In AC loco, the following items to be checked in all bogies for any cracks at vulnerable locations of bogie frame: transoms, cross members, horn cheeks, primary helical springs, proper fixing of traction motor gear case bolts, resilient plaid width bolts, axle cap bolts, TM inspection cover and its bolts, pedestals, all items in braking arrangement, wheel and wheel tire. Along with these items, TM gear case oil points, TM cables, temperature of axle box and handbrake condition, that is its chain condition. Along with the above items, the following specific item also to be checked for a specific type of loco. So long and short equalizing beams, so sat tie rods number, axle crown, oil points, center pivot oil point, side bearer oil point, TM suspension, if it is a Tawa motor, suspension bearing upper sump oil point, lower sump oil point. In gear case you have to check the cardan compound oil level. In WG7 coco tetra mount high addition bogie, so compensating beam to called as a W brackets. These compensating beams are connected to the equalizing beams with the help of links and bulbs. You have to check the links and bulbs and their shims and quarter pins, vertical horizontal dampers, rubber load bearers, side load bearers, rubber side stoppers, D-link. WP4 coco flexi coil bogie with H-type baluster. In this secondary suspension is provided, in this secondary suspension secondary helical springs are provided, H-type baluster, friction motor that is spring loaded with snubbing piston. You have to check all these items. In WG9 WP7 coco flexi coil bogie in three phase locos, so wheel set guide rods, traction links and their fixing bolts, torque arm, dampers, vertical horizontal air dampers, underslung compressors, fixing bolts and their safety slings for traction link, traction motors, MCPs, TM mounting plate and its fixing bolts, secondary springs and dampers. These all are the important items to be checked in exclusive for that particular type of bogie. With this we will complete the bogie topic.